What up, folks? Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts 2. I'm your host, GrandPyromania, and on the last episode, we fought a mysterious figure on top of a mountain, that mountain to be precise, and we found out there's a huge Heartless coming to attack China, so we're gonna go ahead and save China again. Alright, so let's go forth and warn the Emperor. And now we have a bunch of Heartless to deal with. So, of course, this is ample time to go ahead and practice and level up some of our forms. Most specifically, the Master Form. Because, okay, the Master Form is like ultimate technique, or like the combo finisher, I guess, would be the correct word for this, is basically like Sora starts spinning right round like a record player, and he actually like completely like sucks people in and destroys them. It's pretty awesome, actually. See, I'm actually doing it right now, and he's spinning around like a record player, and it sends everyone flying. And luckily, we will... Come on, let's use Bolt Reversal to get rid of you. And dang, that did quite a bit of damage. Let's go ahead and annihilate this last charger, as I believe our thing goes... Or our drive finally ran out. I apparently can't talk, but... Alright, so now these chargers, who gave us a ton of trouble at the beginning of the game, aren't going to give us any trouble at all, because we have Guard Break, and Guard Break pretty much, like, destroys them. It's actually kind of sad. Like, Guard Break is pretty broken, if you ask me. But you know what? I'm not complaining, and I will happily use it. Because, you know what? These Heartless do not deserve fairness. They deserve to be destroyed by the Keyblade, because they are evil, evil beasts. I'm actually kind of wondering if what Xemnas, or Saix, I forget which one, who said was true, and that the Heartless follow whoever's strongest. Does that mean theoretically the Heartless could listen to like Keyblade bearers because they'd be stronger? Or I know it's all against their no evil policy, but it's like, what if you just like kind of control them to do good, you know? I don't know, that's kind of an interesting way to look at it, I guess. But anyway, let's just go ahead and go toward the Imperial Palace.
Open up!
Open here! Oh?
Wait!
Riku?
Oh?
No, never heard of him.
I'm sorry, but that was hilarious. Okay, for those of you guys that didn't know who that was Break. He is indeed one of the Organization 13 members. And so, I'm sorry, I just found it hilarious that he literally walked to the side and everyone's like, oh my god, he disappeared. He must be, like, powerful or something. And then no, Sora's like, oh wait a minute, you ran off to the side. Anyway, we're fighting his nobody... pawns, I guess. They are mainly snipers, and I think there are a few others, but snipers are pretty much his trademark, as his signature gun is his signature weapon is a gun. And so there are quite a lot of these guys, so they can get a bit overwhelming if you're not paying attention. But luckily, like, you can really just honestly abuse the reaction command, and you just warp around and reflect their bullets at them. And yeah. So let's just go ahead and pretty much destroy, like, all of them. Red Rocket, always fun in tight spaces. Not so much elsewhere. Anyway, let's just go ahead and try to destroy these, and there should be one left. Let's see if this is the last one, and indeed it is. Down go the snipers. Guess it wasn't Riku. Sorry, Sora. I can't say, I'm worried about Shang. Oh, right! Oh, not the Emperor. Your Excellency! Shang! Something terrible has happened. We saw a huge monster fly out of the mountains and toward the city.
Ah, so it is as the young man said. Isn't that right, Captain?
Yes, Your Excellency. You see, a young stranger visited us not too long ago. The captain fought the visitor and was quickly defeated. To my dishonor. I love how Shang just kind of turns to him and he's like, really? You're gonna tell everyone? Did he mention the name Riku? He didn't offer his name. He was rather rude. Rude? Then it was Riku! Yeah, definitely not any of the Organization 13 members that kinda kidnapped your childhood friend, Kairi. Riku's in the organization? Gorsh. But why would he come here? And that can't be good. I'll check outside. Mulan! Shang, guard the Emperor! I'll be fine, with them! That's right! Indeed. That is true, we need not worry while you protect us. And don't worry, if you get a game over, I'm sure someone will save you. Hurry! Okay, so, as we've just gone ahead and pledged ourselves, I want you guys to kind of take in this room. I'm sure, as all of you guys know, emperors tend to be rich, and so our services aren't going to be free. Yep, that's right, we're going to go ahead and pilfer everything the emperor has. And so we get the queen recipe, which I believe is the recipe to one of Donald's strongest weapons. We get torn pages, which I would love to put back, but unfortunately I can't. Ah, you wily old goat. You tried hiding some treasures behind your throne, and... you can't get it past me. Get a mithril crystal. And we get Orichalcum. Now, Orichalcum is very, very important, and I'll go into more detailed reason why. But, basically, for those of you guys that haven't played the game, essentially, in a nutshell, and I've said every kind of summating word possible. It will help us get our best Keyblade, our strongest Keyblade. So just kind of keep that in mind. We're not going to be tackling that quest for quite a while. So it's going to be quite a while before we see anything of that, if I do decide to. I didn't in Kingdom Hearts 1, so I may not in Kingdom Hearts 2. I'm not entirely sure. But if I decide not to, then I will say what it's used for, and I will, I guess, give you guys, like, hints or instructions on how to forge this powerful weapon. Anyway, with all that said, let's go ahead and return to the antechamber and go back to the courtyard to go ahead and face what most likely is going to be that huge heartless that was flying towards the Imperial Palace.